There is no question that the proliferation of the artificial intelligence throughout the global economy will result in a massive reformat of the job market. A lot of jobs will be lost, a lot of completely new careers will emerge. What can you, my attentive listener, do about it to find yourself on the right side of the equation? Thank you for listening and subscribing. I am Alex Chadyuk and this is AGI. Listen every Monday morning on your favorite podcast platform. If there is one positive thing about the inevitable emergence of the Artificial General Intelligence, or AGI, is that it will allow us to understand our own intelligence better. One way or the other, losing our domination as the most intelligent species on this planet will shine a much sharper light on what we have been taking for granted all along. If we are to compete with an alternative form of intelligence for the economically profitable employment, we need to get a better understanding of our opponent. It will be an intelligent agent, but not necessarily looking like a humanoid bot, as many tend to imagine these days. Physical strengths and agility aside, what we are interested in is its intelligence. In my definition, the intelligence is the ability to do two things. First, learn the rules of the environment you operate in, and second, find a way to exploit those rules to achieve the goals you are trained for within the internal boundaries you are designed to obey. We will have to leave the goals and boundaries for a future pod. In this one, my thesis is that a specialized intelligent agent that is trained to do a narrow class of jobs really well will always have an advantage over an agent that can do many different things with an average skill. A self-driving robo-car will always be more efficient in getting from A to B safely compared to a generally intelligent humanoid bot driving a traditional car, assuming obviously that both bots have comparable costs to train and manufacture. This means that a designer of a specialized bot will always outcompete the designer of a more universal bot and eventually put the latter out of business. Exactly for this reason, nobody is trying to create a humanoid bot that will replace taxi drivers. The difference in efficiency between a general and a specialized bot is particularly pronounced if the training goal is very complex, like our example of safe driving on the road. Compared to a more general-purpose humanoid bot, a robocar with external sensors and specialized control circuits will have a significant advantage in learning the correct behavior in a very rare but very dangerous situation, giving it a long-term competitive edge in a real competitive market. This means that in the absence of an abject monopoly in the industry, building a generally intelligent bot is not as economically viable as it seems. Each time there is a new market niche in which you are trying to compete by deploying a general-purpose bot, by the time the market matures to the point of generating a stable flow of profit, there is half a dozen specialized bots that will beat you out of that market. The differentiating factor in this competition will be the specific intelligence, which is the ability to learn the specific rules of the new game faster, and then the ability to learn how to exploit these specific rules more efficiently. This is our definition of intelligence applied to a specific market niche. How do we define the AGI in that case? By its ability to generalize the prior learning to achieve the new learning faster. Humans, for the most part, exhibit such capability, which is why AGI is often defined by a comparison with the human intelligence. Now, If we agree that a generally intelligent agent will lose in the competition with a specifically intelligent one in the long term, what about the short term? Being able to generalize the prior knowledge to acquire the new specific knowledge gives a general bot an advantage within the time window that is required for the specialist bot to climb the learning curve from scratch. During this time, the general bot can do two things: earn profit in the newly opened market niche that is not yet served efficiently by a specialist bot, or earn the profit by contributing to training that specialist bot faster. What does this all mean for my generally intelligent human listener? What shall we humans do? As always, first, understand the ever-shifting rules of the environment now that the technology is redefining the labor market yet again. And second, learn to exploit the opening opportunities while the specialist automation is still catching up. There is no use lamenting the disappearing demand for labor in the basic text and video generation, no more than crying over a horse-driven carriage or manual grain harvest. The rules of the environment are changing, and we better internalize that and move on. Our advantage as a generally intelligent agent is in the ability to generalize our prior knowledge to learn the new economically profitable skills faster than the artificial neural network starting to learn the new skill from scratch. AGI is not becoming a reality as fast as many pundits seem to suggest, simply because its economic profitability is compressed from both sides of its efficiency spectrum. At the bottom end, it is competing with humans who are able to generalize and learn new economically viable skills blindingly fast. At the top end of that efficiency spectrum, it is competing with specialized bots that leverage specifically designed sensors and actuators to exploit the new market more efficiently. As I implied previously, there is going to be a big and growing market for human engineers to design and train the specialized bots for a wider and wider array of applied skills. There is a lot of engineering work for young graduates who seem to be put out of business by the AI code generators. The AI will redefine many other sectors of the economy, but my argument is that as long as humans keep learning new skills every day, they will be the first to profit from the newly emerging demand for labor ahead of the AGI and well ahead of any specialized automation. In contrast, if the last time you learned a new useful skill was more than a few months ago and you spend your free time shit-talking the AI on social media, you are basically screwed. And yes, whatever you say on the social media will actually turn out to be true for you. If, on the other hand, you spend your time understanding the shifting landscape of profitable employment and you learn new skills every day to be able to exploit those shifts, your external economic goal will be achievable while your internal constraints of decency and self-respect will be maintained. With this, until next Monday, my friends, I am Alex Chadyuk, and this is AGI.